addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and the order of operation. When we have a question that has addition, subtractions, multiplication, and division, we have to employ the order of operations. Multiplications and divisions are done first, from left to right, and then addition and subtraction, from left to right. Example, if you have 2b times 4c divided by 6a, you will work on the 2b times 4c first, and then divide the result by 6a. Another example, if you have 3a divided by 3c times 4a, you will work out the 3a, divide by the 3c first, and after that, you will multiply by 4a. Let's look at a more detailed problem. When we have 2ab plus 3a times 2b divided by 3b, we know we have to do the multiplication and division first, from left to right. We will work on the 3a times 2b first. Then we divide by 3b. Then we add our answer to 2ab. Please try the following. You don't have to solve. You just have to know how to go about it. Number 1. 4ab plus 2ab minus 2b times 2. You have 5 seconds to try it. Remember, multiplication and division first, and then addition and subtraction next, from left to right. Okay, so let's do it. You will multiply the 2b and 2a first. This will give you 4ab. Then you will add 4ab and 2ab to get 6ab. Finally, you will subtract the 6ab minus 4ab to get 2ab. Let's try another example. 10x squared divided by 5x plus 3y times 3y. Again, we do the multiplication and division first, from left to right. So we can work on the 10x squared divided by 5x. We know how to divide it. This gives us 2x. Now we have 2x plus 3y times 2y. We do multiplication and division first. So we work on the 3y times 2y to get 6y squared. What we have now is 2x plus 6y squared. As we know, we cannot add these two terms because they have different letters. So that is our final answer. Introduction to parentheses. Parentheses is used for grouping. It normally helps us to write expressions in a short form and helps us to know which operation to perform first. Parentheses for order of operation. Let's start with a brief look at parentheses and the order of operation. When we have 2a minus 4a times 2, we know we have to do the multiplication first. We multiply 4a by 2 to get 8a. Then we work on the 2a minus 8a to get negative 6a. There are instances where we want you to work in a different way. Parentheses makes that possible. Let's look at the same example. 2a minus 4a times 2. This time, we will place 2a minus 4a in parentheses. When we do that, we are saying, perform the thing in parentheses first. So, we will work on the 2a minus 4a first to get negative 2a. Then, we multiply it by 2 to get negative 4a. Notice we got different answers. This idea is extremely important, especially in calculators. It is worth repeating that in the order of operation parentheses always comes first. Parentheses for grouping. Let's say we have 2a times 3b plus 2a times 4c. Notice we have 2a in both terms. We can rewrite it as 2a times, in parentheses, 3b plus 4c. Here, we bring the common thing out and the uncommon thing inside the parentheses. Let's look at some examples. 3ab plus 3ac. Here, we notice that the 3a is common in both terms. So we can bring the 3a out, and what will be left is b plus c. We put the b plus c in parentheses. Another example. We have 3ab squared plus 3abc. We know that b squared is the same as b times b. So the common things are 3ab. We can bring it out. We have one of the b's left and the c here. Our final answer is 3ab in parentheses b plus c. Remember when we learned the invisible one? Let's look at another scenario of it. 2ab plus 2a. We notice that 2a is common to both terms, so we can bring the 2a out. This leaves b for the first part. For the second part, we have taken everything, which is the 2a. In a case like this, what we have left is 1. If we have 3b plus 3a, we can clearly see that the 3 is common. it is not always obvious that the numbers are the same. We can have a question like 6b plus 3a. It is not obvious that the 3 is common. If, however, we expand the 6 as 2 times 3, then we can see that they both have 3. We can pull the 3 out and have, into parentheses, 2b plus a. In most instances, it is very easy to identify the common numbers if your multiplication is okay. Parentheses expanding. The same way we can contract an expression, we can also expand an expression. For an expression, we might either want to go from 2ab plus 2ac to 2a into parentheses b plus c, or we might want to go the other way round. This is what expansion is all about. So say we have 2a in parentheses b plus c. We can expand this by multiplying each of the terms in the parentheses by the 2a. So we have 2a times b plus 2a times c. Since your multiplication is good, this should be easy. Exponents. Exponents doesn't pose much of a problem now because we have already looked at the two most important times it is used. This is in multiplication and in division. Let's revise. We take 2a squared times 3a cubed. We remember we have to multiply the numbers first. We multiply 2 and 3 to get 6. We then notice there's 2 a's here and 3 a's here. So we have a total of 5 a's. Our final answer is therefore 6a exponent 5. Here, what we are doing is adding the exponents of same letters. So, a cubed times a exponent 5 equals a exponent 3 plus 5. This equals a exponent 8. This is what is called the first law of exponents. When we looked at division, example, 6a cubed divided by 3a squared, we said we first divide the numbers. We divide 6 by 3 to get 2. Then we say there are 3 a's at the top and 2 a's at the bottom. So there will be 1 left at the top. Our final answer is therefore 2a. Here, what we are doing is subtracting the exponents of the same letters. So a cubed divided by a squared equals a exponent 3 minus 2. This is the same as a exponent 1, which is simply a. This is what is called the second law of exponents.